morning, friends and colleagues. I very much appreciate the invitation by Paula and by Sergio to this event. I'm very happy to be in Como again. When considering the topic for my presentation, I decided to talk about my most recent result. It concerns decoupling or non-interactive control. And it was the long-standing open problem of linear system theory, because the earliest known investigations date back to that date. Maybe I will talk more about that. A state space formulation appeared in 1964, and a solution for the square and invertible system, the simplest case, followed in 67. The general case of right invertible systems, however, was not solved until 2017. Decoupling is a problem of compensating a given system in such a way that each output can be independently controlled by a corresponding system input. So the transfer function of the system is diagonal, or up to a permutation, let's say. The system is assumed to be linear, time invariant, finite dimensional, of course, and decoupling can always be achieved using dynamic compensation. It's a well-known result, which, however, increases the order of the system. The static state feedback does not increase the order, and therefore may involve only the internal dynamics we can spare in the system. And that's why it is so difficult. This formulation will avoid any restrictive hypothesis concerning system and decoupling feedback. And the existence of a solution is shown to depend on the existence of three lists of integers, of non-negative integers, that are conditioned by and only by system invariants with respect to the transformations that are permitted while decoupling. This is a really new result. It will appear in the December issue of the IEEE Transactions of Automatic Control. So, the earliest investigations were made by Wozniacki in Moscow. There are two papers available. They are both in Russian. This one was also translated to English. Then in the United States, it was Box and Bohm and Hood. They were all concerned with the non-interacting control of power station turbines and complex engine types. Following the establishment of transfer function methods, it was Kavanagh who studied in detail the open loop decoupling problem and the problem of internal structure, physical realizability, stability, and so on, received just very little attention. A deeper insight was provided by the state space approach, and the pioneering formulation was by Morgan, who formulated decoupling as a static state feedback problem for square invertible systems. The existence condition posed by Morgan was eventually resolved by Falk and Volovich. Later, in 1971, Morse and Morham formulated the decoupling problem for right invertible systems. And a complete solution was obtained only for the case of dynamic compensation. The static state feedback case was solved under several different restrictive assumptions only. So there have been several partial solutions. Then, in the late 70s, the revival of transfer function methods brought new results also to the theory of decoupling. It was Descus and Dion who related decouplability of square nonlinear systems to their infinite zeros. So the infinite zero structure was shown to be a key information for decoupling. And Como, Descus, Dion, Lapin, Balaber later introduced new decoupling invariants. They called them the essential orders. Autus and Heymann noted that dynamic compensation By this I mean static state feedback applied to the system augmented by integrators. It's equivalent to the 2 degree of freedom compensation and therefore capable of decoupling any right invertible linear system. Dion and Como obtained a decoupling solution for an intermediate case of dynamic state feedback with constant feed forward, however, which is somewhat harder. And there is some solvability condition in this case indeed, and it requires that the number of input variables be sufficiently large. Still very easy condition to satisfy. Decoupling may increase the infinite zero orders of the system. These are invariant with respect to the regular state feedback, but such a change can be made only through non-regular state feedback, which results in a loss of some inputs. Very important result was obtained by Lozo, who presented a sufficient and necessary condition for the desired infinite zero orders to be assigned via non-regular static state feedback applied to the system. This result was used by Desquislafe Malaber to obtain a decoupling solution in the almost in the general case, but however later the condition was shown not sufficient, only necessary, by Herrera, Hernandez and Lafay, who noted that the essential orders are not necessarily preserved while decoupling the system, which was originally believed. This feature in fact distinguishes the static state feedback from the dynamic state feedback decoupling. And it, still, the interest in solving the problem continued. There were results by various researchers. For example, Zagala, Lafay, Herrera, Hernandez obtained a solvability condition in the general case. But the condition is implicit, not easily testable. And here there are conditions which are non-structural, so they depend on some entries of some matrices which are not preserved during the decoupling process. And here some very recent result which was presented in Toulouse the last week, but this concerns only a system which assumes a very simple structure, however, since by far not the general solution. So here is the problem formulation. Our approach is different from other approaches, and we aim to obtain an explicit solution condition to solvability conditions which are structural, which use only the invariants of the system which are preserved by decoupling. And the approach consists in bringing the system to a special form called a decoupling standard form via a sequence of permissible transformations. So we consider the linear system ABCD like that, and the transfer function therefore is a P by M transfer function. And by decoupling we mean determining a list of P non-negative integers and a controller FG of this form, static state feedback, where V is a new external input of dimension P, the same dimension as the output has, such that the closed loop system transfer function matrix given by this formula is diagonal, apart from a permutation matrix multiplier. And here are the integers R1, R2. The problem cannot be solved for any general system. The most general system for which decoupling can be solved are right invertible systems satisfying this condition. P is the number of outputs, M is the number of inputs. So we need at least as many inputs as outputs, and full rank. The decoupled structure, of course, is desirable in a number of applications. The solution relies on fundamental concepts from linear system theory, like system invariance, canonical form, system transformation, feedback realizability of precompensators, modification of infinite zero structure, and so on, and so on. So it's very difficult to describe simply the result, but I will do my best. System transformation to the decoupling standard form reveals systems invariants, and these are finite zeros, infinite zero orders, column minimal indices. There are no row minimal indices because the system is invertible, and essential orders. With respect to the group of transformations which are permitted by decoupling, so it's state feedback, non-singular input and state coordinate transformations, and output permutation. Here is the decoupling standard form. This is the input-output part of the problem, it's block one. This is, there are several more inputs than outputs, so this is the so-called strongly controllable part of the system, which has no outputs, and therefore it is controllable under any possible output injection. And there are invariant zeros. We define fictitious outputs here, so as to have as many inputs as outputs, just to see this dynamics also in the transfer function. Now, the form of block one and block two is like this. It consists of chains of integrators, which are coupled or cross-coupled. And because of that special structure, the transfer function of the system in decoupling standard form has a triangular form where these are couplings, these are cross-couplings, and here are the numbers of integrators in the chains, and these are infinite zero orders, and these are co-minimal indices. And the elements here are all polynomials in S inverse. And we can say that the system, when it is brought to the decoupling standard form, is already as much decoupled as possible using regular static state feedback. The rest has to be achieved by non-regular static state feedback, and that's the difficult part. We also define the interruptor, which is the transfer, which is the inverse of this input-output block. Inverse of it, which was introduced by Lovich, and the diagonal degrees of the interruptor are the infinite zero orders, and the column degrees are the called essential orders. If these two are different, decoupling is difficult. The conditions are expressed in terms of some lists of non-negative integers. So, let's consider a list of non-negative integers like that. And we define the index set, J, of the set, as the positions of the non-zero elements. Index position of the non-zero elements. Therefore, the number of non-zero elements of the list is the cardinality of the index set. We sometimes find it useful to denote the diagonal matrix like that as capital lambda related to this list, which is shorthand notation. It's not this one. Now, important property of lists of integers is as follows. Consider two lists of non-negative integers, lambda and mu, and order them in the non-decreasingly manner and call them the lambda star, mu star. Then we say that lambda dominates or majorizes whatever mu, write it like this, if and only if this set of inequalities holds. This means lambda 1 star greater than or equal to mu 1 star. Lambda 1 star plus lambda 2 star greater than or equal to mu 1 star plus mu 2 star, and so on. This property is very natural and important for all kinds of polynomial matrices, no matter whether in S or in S inverse. In fact, any such a non-singular matrix, in any such, the column degrees dominate the invariant zero orders. You see, the column degrees are 2 and 3. Invariant factor orders are, invariant factors are S to the minus 1, and S to the minus 5 divided S minus 1, so it's 4. So the invariant factor orders are 1, 4, and you see, 2 is greater than 1, 2 and 3 is equal to 1 plus 4. Okay? So this is very natural relationship between column degrees and invariant factor orders. And this will be heavily used. Here are the solvability conditions. We are given a right invertible system with the list of infinite zero orders, with the list of column minimal indices, and the interactor and the essential orders. The system can be decoupled by static state feedback if and only if there exist three lists of non-negative integers called epsilon, eta, eta star, where eta star is the selection of the elements of eta, not all of them, it's a different number, which are placed at the positions where epsilon has non-zero elements. Okay, like this. Such that the following conditions are all satisfied. There are six conditions where, in addition, omega is the list of the orders of the invariant factors, the orders of this special matrix related to the interactor. These conditions are set to, they form the so-called constraint dominance problem, because there is the most important dominance condition here, and the rest are some constraints. If these conditions hold, then an FG is a decoupling feedback law, because it's not unique, of course. The transfer function matrix of the decoupled system is diagonal with R1, R2, RT, the integers here, which are given as epsilon plus rho. And pi is a permutation matrix. So this is the substance of the problem. And the most important part and most difficult is to select these three lists of integers. Epsilon specifies an increase of infinite zero orders required to achieve decoupling. We have to add some integrators, take them somewhere else in the system, and epsilon specifies how many of them we need. Eta describes which part of our reserve integrators are to be used to achieve this increase, and eta star indicates how these are connected to the external input terminals. So this is the meaning of these lists. And when all the strongly controllable chains are free, decoupling is simple and amounts to solving one constraint dominance problem only. However, when some of these strongly internal controllable chains are coupled with the input-output chains, the decoupling is difficult. It cannot be reduced to a single dominance problem. In fact, the solution involves a family of constraint dominance problems indexed by the coupled chains. For each coupled chain, we have a constraint dominance problem. The connection of a coupled chain, we select one coupled chain connected to some input terminal, then we have modified the system. And we solve the constraint dominance problem for this modified system. If it doesn't yield a solution, we try another coupled chain and another connection and so on. And in this way we find these numbers like that. And then, when these lists are selected, we apply elementary row and column operations on this matrix so as to determine the dynamic decoupling compensator, which has the property that it is realizable via static state feedback. Then we transform the system back to the original coordinates. These operations can be visualized in the very simple cases as follows. Suppose we have such a system which is already in the decoupling standard form, input-output pair, the strongly controllable internal chains. n number of inputs, 5, p number of outputs, rho, 0, 0, 3, infinite 0 orders, sigma, 1, 3, these are the cold minimal indices, and when you calculate the interactor, you find that the essential orders are 3, 0, 3. And there is one coupled chain, you see here, cross-coupled chain. So, what we have to, what we have to do is to first to eliminate this coupling. There are three integrators here, so when we put three integrators here, we can do it. You see, we borrow from here, we connect them here, 3 and 3, 3, 3, here is a coupling. So we add the minus, same coupling, and this is eliminated. Okay? But unfortunately, because of this coupling, we introduced another coupling here, unwanted. So we will have to do a similar thing. There is, before the coupling, one integrator here, so when we put one here, and we still have it here, fortunately enough, we put it here. Okay, so this is the coupling, which still, so we put it here, okay, and we plus, minus, and the system is decoupled. And the R integers are 3, 1, 3, okay, 3 in channel 1, 1 in channel 2, and 3 in channel 3, and cross couple is decoupled. It's very easy, intuitive. Slightly more difficult situation is that there are two couplings here, and no cross coupling. So now we have to eliminate this coupling. So we need three integrators put here. Unfortunately, we have two and two. So we can put only two. And we put it like that. To have three in the first channel. You see? Like this. We have to borrow one integrator because we have not three in one chain to have it here. Then, to eliminate this coupling, we need two integrators here. Only one, because one is here. So we need one only here. But here, not one, we have two. So we put two. So that's the elimination. Okay? So we put two and use only one. This one is left. Okay? And this will be used to eliminate the cross couplings created unintentionally. You see, like this. And the system is decoupled. But you see, it's much more tricky. This is the decoupling feedback. Okay? It's much more tricky, and still this is a difficult case. So you understand that really we need the theory behind to solve the general cases. So I just wanted to illustrate what is really done by those column and row unimodular operations, okay, shifting the integrators and comparing the degrees and the invariant factor orders of the transfer function. So, the decoupling problem is conceptually very simple. Diagonal transfer function is very appealing, but its solution is really very, very difficult. It is of interest to solve the problem under the additional constraint that the decoupling system be stable. Stability has not been included. This is even more difficult and requires further research. When you solve one problem, you generate two new problems. So one of them is decoupling with stability. Thank you.